Thai massage, or Muay Thai as is its traditional name, is an ancient healing art of Thailand. It is heavily influenced by Indian medicine, Ayurveda and Chinese medicine, as well as by various indigenous traditions. It is an integral part of Thai traditional medicine, which is an autonomous system. According to the principles of this healing system, the human body contains certain meridians through which cosmic energy flows. These meridians are called sen, which means line in Thai. One of the main goals of Thai massage is the balancing of these meridians. Thai massage also contains stretches, adjustments, and typical massage techniques. Thai massage is traditionally practiced on a mat. The receiver should wear light and loose clothing. The therapist uses his thumbs, palms, elbows, forearms, knees and feet, or sometimes his whole body, in order to perform the techniques. Now, let us see how it is done. Traditionally, a Thai massage session begins from supine position. Actually, traditional Thai massage has a protocol. The therapist moves from the receiver's feet to his head. Thus, the session opens with the feet techniques. These techniques create a feeling of trust between the therapist and the receiver. Also, as they induce a very pleasant feeling of relaxation, they help the receiver to surrender to the therapist, who will proceed with far more dynamic and interactive work in the next steps of the session. In order to place the receiver properly for the following Thai massage techniques, open his feet at the width of his shoulders and kneel in front of his feet, keeping your back straight and relaxed. If you feel that you should protect your knees, please kneel on a pillow. Walk on the inner arch of the feet with the heel of your hands. Work with your body weight. Never apply pressure from your shoulders. Be careful not to apply pressure on the metatarsophalangeal joint and the ankle. Then, press three points under the ankle. These points are supposed to balance the energy. Then grasp the receiver's feet and rotate them towards both directions. Your grip should feel steady but not tight. Now, bring the receiver's feet close to one another and press them downwards. Then, push the receiver's feet upwards towards her head. And repeat. Place one foot above the other and press both feet downwards. Repeat with the other foot on top as well. Do not perform this technique on osteoporotic women. Place your fingers on the dorsal aspect of the receiver's foot and your thumb on the plantar aspect. Using your thumbs, apply pressure on the calatari sen. Do not apply direct pressure on the toe joints. Just rub them gently. Work from the big toe towards the pinky toe on 5 lines. At the end of each line, pull gently the toes. Now, follow with your thumbs the Ita and Pingala Sen lines on the dorsal aspect of the foot. Again, work from the big toe towards the pinky toe on 5 lines, doing gentle circular friction. At the end of each line, pull gently the toes. Place the receiver's foot on your thigh. Using your thumbs, press 6 points on the foot. When you finish working on the 6 points on the one foot, place it gently on the mat and repeat this technique on the other foot as well. Using your thumbs, press the inner arch of both feet simultaneously. Do not apply pressure on the metatarsophalangeal joint. These techniques are considered suitable for the treatment of plantar fasciitis during the chronic phase. Other traditional indications include painful, tired feet, headaches, and stress. It is believed that acupressure on the feet brings the energy down, thus removing the tension away from the body.